Now let's go over to Kim Hudson here to continue the 9 a.m. show. Good morning, Kim.
Good morning, Lisa. You know, the bottom line is we have to make sure that it's running season, that the humans get involved, but also that our four-legged friends get involved too. Standing right next to me, we have Trisha Tialdo, chair and board member of the Race for Rescues 5K. We also have Shoshana Mustaller. She is program director for the Belleville Area Humane Society. Let's go ahead and start with Trisha. I see a gorgeous little one up there. What's his name?
His name is Edison, and he is available for adoption. He's a two-year-old, and he is great with kids.
He is. He is just so chill. He has a fair amount of energy, but he is just so, so chill. And what's the name of you guys' mascot?
Vegas.
Vegas. Oh, see, Vegas didn't. But that's why Vegas was so quiet. Vegas wouldn't tell us anything. Tell us about the 5K. And also, I understand that dogs can come, but how should we prepare them if we're going to be running in the 5K?
Well, the 5K is on Sunday, April the 22nd at Belleville West. It goes from 9 to noon in Belleville, Illinois. And yes, it is dogs and humans can come. And the best way to prepare with your dog is kind of like the same way that you do the Couch to 5K training. And you can walk or run with the dog the day of the race, but the best thing to do is take your dog out and maybe run with him or her for 5 minutes and walk then. And each day just increase the time a little bit.
Okay. All right, so we definitely have to make sure that we train the dogs too. Just because you're an ultramarathoner doesn't mean you can take a couch potato with four legs and run them. Shoshana Mostaller, program director, Belleville Area Humane Society. You guys have a walk-a-thon, but also before we get into that, I mean, you guys do a lot of really great things for the dogs, not just provide shelter, right?
Yeah, we have a lot of stuff that we do with the dogs. Sometimes when dogs come to us, they come from, you know, we don't actually know where they come from. We get them from animal control. We get owner surrenders. We don't know a lot about their background. So we do a lot of training with them and a lot of assessment to see whether they're going to be good with kids, you know, what their temperament is, so that we can make sure that people get the exact appropriate dog for them.
And how does the walk-a-thon work?
So the walk-a-thon, you know, we've been looking for ways for a long time as an organization to get kids involved. So kids always want to help kids, right? Like help animals. They love dogs. They love cats. How can they get involved? So one of the things that we thought about was a walk-a-thon. Anyone can do it. So children just pick an amount that they would like to walk, an amount of miles, and then they can do it with their dog. They can borrow a dog. They can do it on their own.
And
but just get pledges.
Yeah,
you just get pledges to walk that amount. And then if they want to come to the race, there's a children's race that day, a fun run. It's a 1 mile fun run.
Oh, that's off.
Make that one of your miles.
We actually have a much shorter race right now. We're going to have Vegas. And I'm sorry, who's our little one
Edison.
Again? We have Vegas and Edison run against each other. Here's the finish line. Let's go ahead and see what we can do. 3, 2, 1. Let's let it rip. Let's go. There you go. I wonder who's going to win. I wonder who's going to win. Edison! Congratulations. Here, Edison, here. He's so excited. He can't even get his medal here. Everybody, it's the Race for Rescues, Belleville West High School, April 22nd, 9 until noon in Belleville. Register at bahspets.org/events. The ones with the four legs have the advantage here on the 9 a.m. show.